da. Well, hello there, you malt mafanways. Ralphie here with Whisky Review 146. And we're going to leave Scotland behind for a few reviews. And we are heading to other parts of the British Isles. Because nowadays, here in 2010, whisky is really becoming a very international beverage. Not in terms of people drinking the stuff, but in terms of countries and regions producing the stuff. And what I have here is a bottle of Penderyn Welsh Whisky. Intriguing. Let's have some. Now, a little bit of background here. Tall, elegant, distinctive bottle. Unmistakable packaging. Good. this is the first whisky to be produced in Wales commercially in over 100 years. It is situated in the Brecon Breacons, a rather ancient part of Britain, and pretty hilly too, and just in the tiny village of Penderyn in Mid Glamorgan. Lovely. It is considered one of the smallest distilleries in the world, if not the smallest, though there is some debate over that, and I would question that. And it has also got a rather unusual and exotic still and some unusual and exotic products in Breacon's gin, Brecon gin, vodka and Merlin cream liqueur. That's a few of their portfolios. And it's interesting to note that there has been a lot of public support for a small, unusual distillery elsewhere in the British Isles outside of Scotland, and why not? And it's been pretty well received. Now, I have to say that when Penderyn Distillery opened for business, the first whiskies out in the market, they were kind of variable and still very young. However, I have noticed from sampling the Penderyn range over the last couple of years that there is some seriously good whisky being made at that distillery. Very distinctive, very original, and rather marvellous. So what do we think of this one that we bought in the supermarket recently? It's winning awards. This is the Or Cymru. I probably pronounced it wrong, but let's get on with it. 46%. Is it chill filtered? Don't think so. And I don't think they'll be adding caramel. The sensible people. Right. Nose. There's a real syrupy maltiness going on here. And there is a real warm, spicy note. Cinnamon. A sort of wood cinnamon. There's a red fruit note, a cranberry thing going on here. For whisky that is still relatively young, and this is no more than, what, about 6 years old? Possibly five. It's come a long way in a short space of time. There's still an edge to it, a certain heat on the nose that kind of reminds me that this is still young whisky. But I am so looking forward to buying a bottle when this is 12, 14 and 17 years old. They do a range from sherrywood, portwood, different single cask bottlings, which have been winning awards. So it's a pretty young, small team of folk, and they are doing a pretty good job. There's a slight gluey note here, but and there's mustard as well. There's kind of a hint of French mustard going on. It's really quite intriguing. Flavour. Now it's 46%, so I will be adding water, malt mates. Let me see. That is a lot better than my first experience of Penderyn. But it's not quite up to the level of the experience of Penderyn I had at the Victoria Whisky Festival a few months ago in Canada. The Penderyn at the table there was truly spectacular. Well into the 90s. I wouldn't give this Penderyn 90, not there yet, still too young, still a touch of edginess going on here. I will give this one, I was going to give it 85, but there's a quality, there's a quite a charm in the finish of this whisky, so I'm going to head up to 86, and I'm going to try it again. It's a malt mark, guys, it is a malty mark. And I'll put my nose into it. Ah, now there's some more herbal. There's a Manuka honey, Australian honey note there. This is moving around now in the glass. In terms of smell, anyway. Slight chlorine note. Pine, Cypress. There's a wee reminder there of actually of Canadian Glenbretton whisky, funnily enough. It's got a bit to go yet, but this whisky's well on the way to being very good indeed. I would conclude by saying that there are a few unadventurous whisky drinkers who will tell you that it's got to be single malt from Scotland because they are the best, fair dues. I do believe that Scotch whisky is and can be the best in the world. However, with such an array of opportunities now to try whiskies from Japan, America, Canada, Wales, England, yes, England too, Ireland, India. It's worth going into the liquor shop and just for a change, pick something off the shelf that you wouldn't dream of buying. Chance it. It might not work. Swap the bottle with somebody. But alternatively, you might discover a new whisky, which is such a revelation to your experience, and that you learn so much from something new. Even the experts and so-called experts are always through learning. It's a vanity to consider yourself a master of a particular subject. We're all students in life, all of us, without exception. There we go. If you want to know more, you know where to come, ralphie.com. Yeah. See you soon.